Bring the ball.
Papi, chequea la pizza dentro.
Shake and bake, baby. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
See my story, got a straight flat. Aim shots, not behind the camera. I mean behind the hammer. Leave a piece like a diagram. A die in a hair blunt.
Yes!
Double shotty like a band. Missing money in my eyebrows. Ow. Lift up the 5 pound. Quicker than butter. I view the mountains once the sun's up. Do anything to get the funds up. Motherfuckers is on the bus.
Look at this. Que bella.
You take steps to get to the sex. I just flex. Like Lex, dance moves with the pecs.
Okay, so Industry Pizza born in 2016, and I was working in a restaurant in the city, and the guy was bringing the flour to us. He was like, yo, Massimo, there is a pizzeria for sale close to your house. Why you don't get it? And I'm like, yo, I never made pizza before. I don't know. Like, let me go talk and we see. And then I went to talk with this guy and he was like, yo, I'm old. I want to get out. Okay, you know, let's find the deal and we're going to make it happen. So, and now I'm fucking stuck here, you know, from like fucking 4 years with this guy. I mean, no.
Yeah, we met when Massimo first came from Italy. So I met him when he came here. He didn't speak any English. Couldn't really find a lot of people to work, and we were talking back and forth. I was working in a kitchen at the time as a sous chef, and Massimo wanted to really focus on the dough. So I could focus on the toppings. He could really focus on making the best kind of dough he could make. So it kind of worked out really well.
We wanted to make the lightest dough possible. You see the little crust that we have here with all this bubble? This one is the crack. When you eat the slice, very like super fucking crunchy and, you know, airy and delicious.
I always describe the pizza as like if you're from New York, but your parents send you to Italy every summer, and you come back and you make pizza. I'm from here, Massimo Familia, so I really think when you eat this pizza, you kind of really understand the two backgrounds colliding.
So today we're gonna make some focaccia, porchetta, we're gonna make la maggiore, we're gonna make pizza, it's gonna be a fucking big day, you know? We're gonna make a bunch of stuff. My God, you bring me money?
No, first I gotta fucking...
Oh, Jesus, I hate that stuff. Come on.
I got a nice kettlebell for us that we're gonna do squats with. And I got some beautiful peppers as well.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Look at this bounty.
It's from the Queen's Finest Market?
Yeah, my fridge. I left that half onion in there. Brought some beautiful new olive oil. Grove and Vine times Bronson, you already know that.
This is the one from Chile?
Come this way, though, before we even talk about anything.
God, fucking asshole.
We have to do 100 squats no matter what. Come on.
It'll wink at you.
Let's go. No, lower, lower, lower. Ass low. Yeah. One.
No pain.
10 more. Come on. 9. One more. There it is.
Jesus. Yo, it's 70.
That's 72. I just got that in the mail. Look at this. Look at that fucking stance. He knows what he's doing. He's built for power. This is the new lifestyle. If we're gonna eat, we're gonna fucking lift. We got 40 more to go, and then we're gonna have 100 squats in.
No, no, let's make the focaccia now, come on.
What are you gonna do? We're doing tomato?
We have to make the focaccia.
We gotta bake this focaccia together.
Look at how beautiful this is. You see these air pockets of love? That's good fermentation right there. That just means more happiness, airiness, area for more crisp and crunch. You put a little bit of pressure in there with your fingers so you can put all the goods in there.
What I usually love, I like the juice from the tomato.
Oh, yeah.
So you can help me to fill it up.
You don't want to demolish the tomato. Just get a little juice, huh?
Just a little juice, yeah.
I got you. You put salt on this now or
no,
later?
No, we go later.
Okay.
Action, you want to come see the dough?
Yes, I would love to.
This is the bigger, action. So this is going to be the starter for the focaccia, you know? And we let it proof for like 18 hours at room temp.
Yeah,
okay,
what's
so
bigger?
There is two ways to do a pre-ferment. There is the Polish, which is a liquid pre-ferment, yep. And there is Biga. Biga is the driest one. You need to smell like alcohol.
Yep.
Acidic.
And you know, acid.
Yeah, you get that acidic smell immediately.
Correct. When you're gonna eat the focaccia, you're not gonna feel heavy and it's gonna be super light.
There's a lot of science behind this, you know, like.
You have to figure it out. It's only about like time and, you know, temperature.
It's like a Jamie Moyer fastball.
Kind of. So now we're gonna add the semolina flour. When you use a pre-ferment, the yeast inside the biga is kind of now lazy. You need something, you need some sugar to get back and alive, you understand?
Gotcha.
So you want to use a little bit of malt. You can add just a little bit. How do you say? Pinch or punch?
A pinch or punch. Punch or pinch. Punch or pinch.
Pinch or punch. Pinch or punch.
You know, sometimes possible, you don't make no fucking sense.
Just mix a little bit.
Damn, look at that focaccia already looking beautiful.
Yeah, man, it's going.
Bro, that looks beautiful.
The bottom, we have to finish it on top of the egg.
Oh, and then you finish it on the stone for a second?
Just for a second.
Ah, blah, look at this. My fucking lord. Oh, see, now you hit it with the song? And then this, oh, that's fucking beautiful.
You gotta make sure it gets on this crust on top there. Sorry, is that what you wanted to do?
No, I just wanted to watch you do it. I'm a cuck. Carb cuck.
Carb cuck.
I just watch fucking people make bread and fucking, you know what I mean. Such a fucking thing of beauty. Oh. This, we have to taste while it's hot.
Never get old.
Oh my God, man. Look at this, see the smile? He wants to smile. The softness, and I don't know, this is very delicate to me, I don't know.
It's like a pillow.
That's exactly what it is. It's unbelievably light and pillowy.
We're making some focaccia for the porchetta.
This is a magic den. This is a magic playhouse here. Look at that fucking thing.
We did an overnight braise on this.
This is exactly where I'd apply for a job. Oh, look at
you.
Will
you take that agent?
Of course, that's what you do.
You gotta rub the top of that in the pork fat.
You're getting stupid.
Yeah, this is it. There's no juice.
That one is called Diddy
Job. Oh my God. Bro, I'm frozen in time right now from what you just did.
You hear that?
Oh, did I hear it? The acoustics in here. Hold on, I gotta justify this. For that taste, 25.
25?
Jesus
25.
Christ.
25?
I gotta do these.
Oh, you're doing the poppy shows.
That's how we're supposed to. Right now.
Yeah, that's how we're supposed to.
I'm fucking pumped.
Really?
Yeah. We're gonna make la majuna. It's one of my favorite things in life. With the dough that is made here, it is probably the greatest la majuna on earth. We'll have a few witnesses, let me know if you had a better one, because I've had a lot of them. And I don't think I've had a better one. We're gonna do a couple different versions. You know, we have one with the lamb, and then you have this, like, is this the Persian version? Is it Armenian? Lebanese? Lebanese. It's one of those versions where it's Zatar slurry. Huge. I'm gonna mix the lamb, because I know Massimo wants tartare. Kick it up a notch. Some Calabrian chili. This is the marinade for the lamb. You want this mixture to be, like, wet. You want it to be like the indusia of lamb.
This is the best when it's broke.
I see, mira. Sentado y para. Plano. Plano.
Sí, qué rico.
Oh, yeah. This is the homemade za'atar.
This is gonna go on the la majun that we're making. Tomato, cucumber, kind of pickle situation here. Kind of did it like, they do it in Astoria. They have this like condiment they usually put on like falafel and shit like that.
This is the dough for la majun.
This is the best version of this type of dough I think that could ever be possibly made. Let's let them sit for a second. Let's let them stack. It's like a cracker, but yet when it sits for a little bit, it's rollable. So it's like a magic dough.
They call me the touch with the Dutch.
The touch with the Dutch. What'd you think?
It's pretty good. La majun.
I'll eat all day.
Yeah.
Squat and eat all day. We're gonna have them fucking.
Bitch, I'm a superhero. I wasn't born with De Niro. Somehow I turned into De Niro. Just give me one shot at the lead role. You'll be amazed like the first time you seen snow. Down in Georgia on the beach road. I shoot 95% from the free throw. 60 from the field. Straight sex appeal. The lone gunman.
Industry pizza. We've learned lots of things. Focaccia, porchetta, la majun. We learned different kinds of styles of dough.
Hello.
Hello. I've done over 300 squats since we've been here. Motherfucker.
Knock, knock, knock him out the box, Bronson. Knock, knock him out the box, Bronson.
Can I play? Yo, can I look at them? They're just playing by themselves. What is this? Can I play? Can I play, bro?
Motherfucker.
Come on!